Dear students, in the previous class we have seen two different algorithms. One is a priori algorithms and second one is a FP tree growth. Okay, how to construct the algorithms and how the scanning the algorithms we have seen. Now we'll see the pseudocode for our FP growth algorithm. See, this is the database partition patterns and the database how to make the frequent items by using FP growth. So here frequent patterns can be partitions into subsets according to F list. So in the last class we have seen the construction of the F list of the ordering, how it has been tracing, everything we have seen. Okay, now here the F list has taken F, C, A, B, M and P. From this you have to make the patterns containing P. Patterns having M but no P. So this, in this order we have to make a values. So pattern having C but no A nor B, comma M, comma P. Then pattern F. This completeness and non-redundancy. So in such a way you have to make a order with P, C, A, B, M and P. So in this way you have to frame the patterns. That's what we have seen here one by one. So you will see, start at the frequent item header table in the FP tree. So this is our header table. It has been given here. You see, first one is a null set. Traverse the FP tree by following the link of each pattern items P. So here you see here F. So the link has been taken over here. F is 4. You see C value is 4. See, traverse the FP tree by following the link of each frequent item P. Accumulate all the transform prefix path of the items P to form P's conditional pattern base. You see here, this before going for a conditional patterns, we'll trace this link first. You see here it is starting from the null tree. So here you see F. The first one, the link is here. You see F 4 and the link is given here. So it is going to the place F. Okay, and then it is traced till here. If you see the value C, C has been taken the link from here, and A, you see A has taken the link from here. B is a header, it has been taken, see B is taking the link from here, and M, see M is taking the link from here, and similarly P is taking the link from here. So like that, first you make the header link to the particular item where it has been starting. Okay, these are all the items where we have written it. So if C has been happened based on F, that is the conditional pattern base. So C is having F. 3 times C is followed by F. So we are writing F. If you see A is followed by F and C. See, A is followed by F and C for 3 times. Similarly, you take B. B is, see, there are 2 places in the B. So here we are having one B value. Here we are having one B value. If you see this B, the previous value, if you see F, C, A, that means your B has been followed by F, C, A for 1 time. And similarly, this B is followed by 1 time from F. So that was just given from 1, and this B is followed by 1 time from C. Okay, so that means F has been combined with, sorry, B has been combined with F, C, A and F and C. That means B is combined with C for 1 time, and B is combined with F for 1 time, and B is combined with F, C, A for 1 time. And if you come for the B, you see here, B is having the value 2 along with F, C, A. See, F, C, A here 1 time, and here also 1 time it is existing. That is path if you trace it, F, C, A, B. So, F, C, A, B one time. So, if you come for the P, see this is the path. So, F, C, A, M. So, 2. And one more P value is also there. That is C, B. This value is 1. So, this is the way how to take a conditional pattern basis. So, the items, how long it has been combined with the other items, it has to be taken. So, when you are comparing for a priori algorithm, your FP algorithm scans at only once. So, multiple scans are not there and the combination is also very easy when you are comparing for the FP growth with the a priori algorithm. We will see once again here. So this is the original data sets we have given here. So from that we are making the number of single item, how many times it has occurred in the database, and we are checking with the minimum support count. So it is 3. So it should be equal to 3 or more than 3. So in that way we are writing the values and then we are arranging in the descending order. And which are not having the value 3, that will be eliminated from the list. So the path how to trace it has been given over here. See, from here we are tracing F, how many times F has happened. So 4, 3, C is 4, so you can count here, 3 plus 1 is 4, A is 3, so you are getting A is equal to 3, and B is 3, so here one time B plus 2 plus 3. So the count should also come correct, and M is 3, so 2 plus 1, 3. And P is also 3, 2 plus 1, it is 3. So like that we are framing this one. Now we will be seeing how the single items can be combined into patterns. I suppose the algorithm has been given. If we take down this algorithm, so we can make use a conditional pattern. So with that conditional pattern, we are framing the transform prefix path and we are combining the items here. If you see here, in the frequent item sets in the descending order, we are writing here. And how to combine it? First, we have to make a header files to all the items which is given in this one. So like that, we have to trace the path. So now here, see here, if I want to go for P, has to come along with M, A, C, and F. So similarly, one P, another P has to come along with the list C, P. So if you see, F, P is coming along with F, C, A, M. And C, P. So similarly, M, you see, what is the previous items are? F, A, C. So F, A, C, it is coming for twice. Then if you see another M, where